afternoon, good morning, wherever you are. Welcome to my channel. Today on my channel, I'm doing low carb meat pie with wholemeal flour, using split flour today on my channel. And on display are some of my vegetables we'll be using today. On here displayed, I have sliced spring onions, shredded carrots and sweet potatoes. I have some shredded white potato as well and peeled in water. Saucepan and a spatula. I have turkey minced meat and chicken. I have milk, oil, baking soda, onion pepper, nutmeg, peppercorns and parsley, ginger and salt, curry, spray oil. I have garlic and another garlic on the side there that you see, and I have egg that I'll be using later for the baking and then spreading on it for the color and the flourishing. And also we have maggi there on the green one, vegetable maggi. So we're going to start by putting in some oil. The pan is already hot. I'm going to put a bit of oil to start cooking. Put in our onions to begin frying. And stir gently until it's cooked. And then we add our meat. Stir continuously and then gently stir and leave to cook for a while and add. So for our flour, guys, we'll be using spelt flour. Spelt flour is most of the most popular wholemeal grain non-wheat flour available. It has nutty and sweet flavor and comes with great many benefits. It's very smooth and easy for digestion and great for all recipes in the baking. So onto our cooking, guys. Our onion is ready. As you can see, it's fried nicely, and we're going to add our minced meat at this stage. Put in your chicken and minced meat and gradually break into pieces into the fried onion so that it seasons well during the cooking process. Stir gently. Gradually breaking in. And continue stirring so that it's marinates into it nicely. It cooks nicely. Keep using the spatula or whatever you're using to cook till it's ready. Thank you.
still mash it. A lot of people say, how about you just still mash it? I don't think it would be too much. Baking, enjoy everything together. So stay tuned for that.
So guys, next onto our mince meat, we're going to add our flour mixture. I'll be using the split flour and a bit of water. Before that, I have some maggi in my hand, so I'm going to add that to give it some bit of flavor. Because it's vegetable, it gives it a really nice taste and it brings all the vegetable flavors together. So that's what I'm doing right now. Just remove it from the sachet and then gently mix it into the vegetables. I'm just using one hand at a time, so that's why you see me struggling there. You can you can just put the flour in just as it is on the powdery state. Or alternatively, what you can do is mix it with a little bit of water, like I will see in the video later. Because the vegetables and meat brought a bit of juice in the sauce during cooking process. You can easily bind in for your meat pie filling when it's cold and ready to doing the pie. going back to mix our mixture, getting ready to pour into the cooking, or filling, should I say. Stir gently until it's nice and done and smooth. I use wholemeal, guys, a split flour wholemeal I talked about earlier in the video. So now we can put it in. It's already nice and done. As you can see, guys, not so much water, just a little bit to bring them all together. The reason I'm doing this is so that it retains moisture in the pie during the cooking process, and the pie is nicely enjoyed. And it's not mushy. Of course, I've grated the vegetables. I didn't cut it. So we move into our dry ingredients and emptying some flour into a red bowl. I did not sieve it, so I'm not going to sieve it at this point because it's just moi. So I just flaked it out and most of my hand through it. We're going to need a big bowl, so you have a free space to maneuver. I'm going to need our baking soda. The baking soda, I think, helped in a bit of the crunchiness, so I think it's very key if you need your baking soda, but you can do it without. You need your baking powder. I added about just a teaspoon, a bit more, teaspoon and a little bit more. And then I added some onion powder. As you can see the name, I don't even want to go there. I don't want to bite my tongue. But it's onion powder, you could get it in a sense grease. I added it for extra taste, it's optional as well. And I added that nutmeg there as well. You can make your own nutmeg powder if you have the nutmeg nuts. But this was 1 pound in a sense grease shop. I liked it, so I added a bit more in there. Just a little bit of salt to taste. Mix all ingredients together. Something a bit different, though you can add margarine or butter. It does itself to use oil. I've been using oil for some time now, it has worked, so I thought I'd throw it into this video so that you have the opportunity and get the option. Let's say you want to do your own pie. Keep mixing, mix all thoroughly. I added just about a quarter of oil. I did not use the whole cup as I showed you in the video. It was looking like it was pretty much absorbed, so I wasn't sure, but it came out right, it came out nicely. It looked crumbled, well crumbled, where the crumble effect, as I was saying. I wasn't sure, so I was contemplating at this point if I should add flour or not. I kept mixing for a while. Until it was all done and looked ready. thing, guys. I wasn't sure, so I added a bit of flour just to give it a bit more consistency. Just wanted it a bit more properly nice texture, and the oil, as I showed you, was just there. I did not add it anyway. I used a little bit, so I'm sure if you're baking, you can use just as little as possible. Maybe a small cup, maybe, and measuring. And this is what I was happy with. After I've added a flour, I added some milk. This is whole milk I showed you earlier in the video. I normally use egg white and then a bit of milk all together. But in this video, I decided to use just milk on this one. I wanted to see the outcome of it as well without the egg. And then use the egg on the coating bit. So you add your milk and then you mix thoroughly so everything is blended together. Continue kneading as much as possible, gently kneading through. This is wholemeal, guys. Spelt flour wholemeal. This is just as good as every other flour we've been using for our baking. Making recipes. I added a bit of milk because it was not all together properly. So you could do that as well. So I added a bit of milk here so that it gives me the right consistency when it's ready for rolling. I added it all together to make sure it's all combined together properly. Promising from here, it's all binding nicely, coming together. A little sticky there, yeah, that was fine. Okay guys, it's almost done. We're going to get it ready and put it in the bag, and then it'll be in the fridge, but you'll see that soon in this video. At this rate, it's ready. When it comes out from the fridge, it'll be ready to roll for us to go. See, moist, moisty texture, very moist. So done. That's how it should be when it's done. Your bowl should be clean when you're ready to go. So onto our bag, sandwich bag, we're going to put our dough and leave it in the fridge to chill a bit. This will help in the crunchiness when it's all baked and done for eating. And then whilst we're waiting, we're going to mix a bit of the remaining milk and some egg whites. I think this was one egg white I showed you earlier, and beat together. Beat until it's well mixed, because we're going to use for the pie coating. And that will give you the golden color of the pie when it's done. Continue beating. If you have a machine that you think you can use to beat, you can go ahead and use it as well. It's all the same thing. then I'm going to use a foil spray and spray into foil. You can use anything of your choice, like margarine and brush, just to grease them, the paper or film. And this is foil. So I have done two in preparation because I don't know how many is going to come out of it. So when it's done, then I'm ready to go. I use spray because it's easier and I don't have to use a margarine or brush. So in preparation, guys, I'm beginning to sprinkle some flour in a very big chopping board, and I'm going to put some around the rolling pin for easy rolling on our dough. You can use any workspace of your choice, but I decided to use a big chopping board that I have, as it will be easier for me. So I put a bit of flour on the rolling pin and wrap it all around, and you can gather the remaining flour to something easily accessible. But right now I'm just spreading around to see if it's all enough, and then if it's too much, I just put some away. Too much, as you can see, so I put some in a tray. I was going to use it earlier, although I didn't want to use it, but there we go. Just spread it evenly around the tray or in the work surface that you intend to use, and then bring out your dough ready from the fridge. Split into two half. I'm beginning to knead a little bit just for get ready for rolling. It's really moist from the fridge, as you can see. So I'm going to leave that in the bag for a minute. Knead for a little bit. With your hands. You can use two hands if you want to, guys. I guess I'd use one hand. Add a bit more flour, because as you can see, you're still taking the flour already put on the chopping board and begin to roll. Roll until flat, but not too flat, because you don't want it to, when you put it together, you don't want it to be difficult to do that. You can add a bit of flour to the rolling pin if you can, to make it easier so that it doesn't stick onto the rolling pin. I kept turning it because there was flour on both sides, and there was flour, so then you allowed it to easily spread during the rolling process. You can use bottle alternatively if you do not have a rolling pin, or for whatever reason you don't have a rolling pin around you. You can make access to a bottle as well. Shape of your choice. This is what I had, and I thought it was big enough to cover the size I want. And then I put a knife of going around it to cut. Well, the edge of the cover I took wasn't sharp enough, so I decided to use knife around it and remove the remaining excess. This is our shape. As you can see, it will cover nicely. Spread your milk and egg mixture you did earlier around the edges. You could use water preferably, but actually I decided to use milk and water. Milk and egg white, sorry, for sealing the insert. And then put your insert in the center. Yeah, I was wanted to cut all the shapes and then begin to fill, but I totally forgotten about that and decided to go on anyway. So this is what we see. I decided to put them together nicely, and instead of knife or spoon for the sealing at the edges, I decided to use my hand to give it a different pattern. we'll see more as we get into this video. Brushed all over it, milk and egg wash. Your fork, that's what I had on me at the time, and then just pierce through so that it cooks evenly and nicely while in the oven cooking or baking. And goes into the tray, and then continue or repeat the same procedure again. A little bit of flour, and continue to roll to for the desired shape you want for the next cutting. If it's not enough and there's another shape you can use that as well. Up to you. Keep rolling until you get a desired shape of your choice. Using the same shape. Initially thought it was quite big, but once I started cutting, I think I was quite happy with it. So I continued and then did the little patches under the turn around for this smooth surface. Fill the pan with my white wash. You can choose to be a bit generous because, as you can see, as we cook it, that was quite a lot. So if you want to be generous, then go ahead. Meat pie is not meat pie without great filling. Anyway. So yeah. And gently bring it together. I think in here you're going to see properly how I did the pattern around the edges. Gently press down to seal the ends nicely. I think here you agree with me that it was quite a different pattern altogether. Really nice. And let me know what you think anyway, guys, if you like this video or you hit it. All over, and this is what is going to give us our golden brown glossy shine when it's finished and the pie is ready. Guys, this is our first batch of meat pie. We're going to put in our preheated oven and continue with our remaining dough, as you will see in the video. So guys, this is our last batch. I'm just decorating the edges and then coating it with our egg wash. The filling is already done, and then I hope you've seen how I decorated the edges and the ones. you will let me know what you think of it. I'm using the fork right now to just pop in. It helps in the cooking process. And then gently lift into your tray. Sorry, that was my salt there. Sorry for that. Yep. Now this is a remaining filling, guys. As soon as it's cold, you can use it for pretty much anything, maybe spring rolls or when you do your meat pie. And you can use it and it will look just as good as new. It was quite a lot, as you can see. And, I was just scraping from the pan. This pie is ready and looks crunchy.
So hello guys, this is our final meat pie made with wholemeal split flour. I've had to do another one again with the remaining mincemeat because the last clip didn't come out well, and so I had to redo it. But if you would agree with me, it's come out a bit much better. It's more crunchier, a bit more yellow, and I had to use milk white for it. See, even though I grated it, doesn't look mashed or anything. Still intact, the carrots, the sweet potato, everything is intact. I don't know if you can see it, and it's really crunchy. And you hear? So, this is our meat pie. You can serve it with a favorite drink of your choice. Very nice. Some smoothies, yogurt, anything you fancy. That is healthy. What more could you ask for? Thank you. If this video was helpful, subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and then let us know what you think. Thank you. Bye.